Hello and greetings from Iceland, where I continue my food journey, despite the fact that the first episode about this subject was not at all what a few of my former subscribers wished for. But I know Icelandic food can be more frightening than a volcano, and the history of our food culture is as rough as our nature can be, and stinky as well, and that is today's subject. Or Iceland's best kept food secret, a secret that you don't see covered in the tourist brochures. This channel is not about to read tourist brochures, and remember that this is not a guide for fine dining in Iceland. December 23rd, every year, a good part of Icelanders get together over a dish that is called Skata. Skata is a fish that has been fermented, so it stinks big time. It is impossible for me to describe the smell, but I can tell you that those who eat it, they are not wearing their Christmas clothes because the stink gets stuck in literally anything. This is said to be an old tradition, or people ate this dish, Skata, the day before Christmas, so they would appreciate the Christmas dinner. And that's logical in a way, but this is, however, a fish that has been rotting for 6 months before it's served, sometimes in sand, and that creates this distinctive ammonia smell that no words can describe. But we have a myth about this process that goes way back, and most Icelanders don't believe this myth, because if they knew what I have seen personally, they would never eat this. But it so happens that I used to work in fish factories in the old days, also as a fisherman for many fishery seasons, so I do know a thing or two about fish and what goes on. So the first part of the story is my own experience, and it's also a story that I've told many times before to Icelanders, but those who have listened to it, they usually don't believe me, or should we say, they don't want to believe me, as I will explain later. And my own story goes like this, that I was working in salt fish processing for a big and very respected company in Grindavík, the volcano town, and occasionally we would get this fish, Skata, from the boats that were coming in with cod and such. And Skata doesn't come in large quantities, just like we can see here from a pier in Grindavík just a month ago, only a few pieces of them. And when we would get it in the house to be processed, there was this lonely fish box standing outside the staff entrance, right here. And they would take the Skata, throw it in a box to rot, and we would usually try to keep away from it due to the smell. But to let the fish rot there, that was not the only process that was going on, because we would see the old timers who were working there go outside during coffee breaks and such, take the lid of the box, swing out all the willy, and piss over the fish. And I must say that me and my friends from up north who came there to work with me, we stood there and watched this and we said, oh boy. But the old timers said, boys, this is just how we give the fish some extra taste, just to make it perfect. This is how it's always been done. And the myth about this process, that people actually piss on this fish to make it stink more and taste better, was no longer a myth. We were just seeing way too much there. So we the younger lads, we stayed away from that box. And to make it short, I have never, ever eaten Skata in my life. But now I'm going to fast forward 10 years. And by that time, I would be living in Reykjavík, a proud owner of a smaller retail store that I operated for over 20 years until 3 years ago. And early on during my retail years, I would notice this growing thing that people were eating this fish on the strongest sales day of the year, December 23rd. So this tradition is relatively new as we see it appear today. And during that important sales day just before Christmas, where I would keep my store extra shiny, everything decorated, everything nice, or until like 1 o'clock when people were coming in, smelling like they were eating fish that somebody had, you know, yeah. And in every civilized country, a storekeeper like me would just ask those people kindly to leave and take the stink with them. But in Iceland, and since this new tradition was going mainstream, I would have got the media against me. talking about this boring storekeeper that's not following up on traditions, ruining the Christmas spirit. So I would be stuck in a store with this smell every Christmas. And what is also strange is that the biggest sales day of the year is no longer December 23rd. It is December 22nd. And I have a theory about it, that the people, normal people, they just won't go shopping when the stinkers are around. And every year I get the same question. Where are you going to do your Christmas skata lunch this year? So I developed this standard answer early on, honest answer. Or, no, I try to stick to food that other people have not pissed over. And I would almost always get the same reply, or, it's just a myth. Yeah, right. And I'm glad to say that there are great many Icelanders who do share my opinion. And one of them is a manager of the House Owner Association. That is the guy who tries to settle things when the neighbor is cooking something spicy and the whole apartment building is smelling like an exotic restaurant. But that's easy to deal with. The worst troublemakers are the Icelanders. So now I'm gonna show you a part of a famous TV interview where this journalist met with the manager of the House Owner Association during this season while he was very pissed off. And I have already added subtitles to it. So here we go.
Ekki tillit sem að sturta svona óþefi yfir saklaust fólk, þetta eins og hryðjuverkar árás á bræðlaukana. Þetta ekki matur, þetta er úldmeti og flokka sem úrgangur samkvæmt öllum skilgreiningum. Og þetta svona barbarískar veislur og bara hryllilegt og líkt sem situr kannski í húsum fram til vori. Svona skötu suða á heima, einhvers það eru búið að öra við með það, annesjum með það, fjarri síðara manna húsum sko.
And after this interview, this poor guy got a tidal wave of angry pissfish eaters telling him to bugger off. It's not his business to tell people what to eat or not. But his work is, of course, to make sure that the neighbors are protected from attacks like this. And this was a few years back. And since then, things have got a bit better. It's a bit more understanding now. So this fish, skata, is today mostly served in restaurants before Christmas, and those who do it at home, they do it in a garden most of the time, like using the gas grill to boil it. But that is also because of bad experience, like throw away the furniture, repaint the apartment, throw away some clothes, all to get rid of the smell. But the smell does, of course, depend on who pissed on the fish that year. I'm going a bit far now. The truth is that the process that I witnessed myself is real, and I have similar stories from elsewhere. So it is no myth that they did it like this in the old days. But as for the process of this fish today, I somehow doubt that this is common practice to piss over it. But the smell is, however, not helping that theory. So I actually don't have any proofs, and I am very sure that modern fish stores would never admit to use this old process, of course. So modern time processing remains a secret, but skata does, however, remain as the most disgusting dish that you can get in our country. And if you would visit Iceland during Christmas, and you are this weird food type of person, you would just have to follow the smell to find a restaurant, stick your head in, smell, and you will soon find out if there is a reason to piss off. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from Iceland.